Economist Cielito Habito says micro, small, and medium enterprises are starved for financial support, which is, in his words, pathetically low compared to other ASEAN members. He says there is a problem with development institutions like Landbank.
Their mission is not to generate revenues for the government as much as they could. Their mission is to serve their particular publics as defined in their charter.
When asked to comment on Landbank's plan to generate more revenues by acquiring at least two-thirds of the Philippine dealing system, Habito said he wasn't privy to the deal. But he still had a bit of insight on whether or not it would be a positive for LBP and its mandate.
You leave to the private sector what the private sector can do best.
LBP President Alex Bonaventura got board approval to acquire PDS to generate more revenues earlier this week, with the backing of Finance Secretary and Landbank Chairman Sonny Dominguez. It's a challenge to the Philippine Stock Exchange, which has been trying to acquire PDS for years to add the local bond market to its stock market operations. Dominguez said the PSE was taking too long to comply with a legal requirement to pair brokers' ownership in the stock market operator. SEC Chairperson Teresita Herbosa earlier said the PSE still has time to pull this off.
We have to see that the stock rights offering will be, will achieve its purpose, which is to make the share structure in accordance with what the law provides, which is that each one should not exceed the industry limit of 20%. I think we should finish it within the first quarter.
But Habito is overall quite happy with the government's handling of the economy in 2017, boosting growth with public spending in the fourth quarter to help the Philippines escape the historic trend of post-election slowdowns. For this year, Habito and the Ateneo Eagle Watch expects growth to remain among the fastest in the region, inflation to stay within target, and the stock market to reach new highs, which it has actually already done. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.